subject to arrest under martial law.
Please put your hands out, sir. Palms together. You will be held in detention until your evacuation center clears you for transport.
Wait,
just
wait.
Take it easy. Take it easy.
Hey, we gotta get out of here.
Wait, what? How did this happen?
The moon. Come on, move it.
That's impossible. What happened?
What, you've been living under a rock?
Yes, I've been living under a rock. Now tell me.
The demolitions for the lunar colony screwed up the orbit, okay? The moon's breaking up, all right? Come on.
As the moon breaks apart in the sci-fi film The Time Machine, and martial law is promptly declared, as if to discipline the collective mind on how to act in case of a deep impact or Planet X event should it occur. Others look to our less fictional skies for the passing of the 10th planet. A shocking report recently posted over at Project Camelot came from a Norwegian politician who allegedly has knowledge of arc-like structures being built all over the world in preparation for such a cosmic disaster. Here are a few excerpts from his letter to them. The Norwegian government is building more and more underground bases and bunkers. When asked, they simply say it is for the protection of the people of Norway. When I inquire when they are due to be finished, they reply before 2011. The Planet X I learned about is from all what I have seen up until now. The government knows this and are keeping it from the public. They have been tracking this object in the sky for a very long time now and were given the first warnings from the USA. I know that 18 bases exist in Norway. I don't know what many of the dangers are because I'm not a scientist, but what I know is that before 2012, the different governments are going to leave for their bases that they have built for the last 40 or 50 years.
Thundar, the Barbarian! The year 1994. From out of space comes a runaway planet, hurtling between the Earth and the Moon, unleashing cosmic destruction.
The ancient Sumerian culture, who apparently were visited by beings from Nibiru on a prior passage, had advanced knowledge of our solar system. They knew exactly how many planets there were, as well as Uranus and Neptune being bluish-green in color. This impossible feat accomplished hundreds of years before the most primitive telescope had been invented. Both in The Time Machine and Thundar, the return of archaic man is a primary theme, all technology being lost to the rivers of time because of an Atlantean-like catastrophe. Here in Thundar, we see a serpent race attempting to make human beings their slaves using death flowers, a form of brain toxin to dumb down the population. Not too unfamiliar from the reptilian element in our own world.
By dawn, the death flowers will be on their way. Kerox, keep their word.
They better. The death flowers are my weapon to defeat the humans beyond the swamp.
We see similar death flowers in Philip K. Dick's The Scanner Darkly. Our Matrix Christ, Keanu Reeves, cultivates the Blue Lotus, a highly addictive and debilitating illegal drug called Substance D, or Slow Death, distilled from small blue flowers, has swept across the country. In response, the government develops an invasive high-tech surveillance system and puts in place a network of informants and undercover agents.
Mighty Set, I heed your call. Let your power flow through the Black Ring. Let the doorway between the dimensions be open. Enter this earthly sphere, Great Set, that I may hear your command.
For thousands upon thousands of years, I have waited for these stars to fall. My liberation is now at hand.
How is this possible, Magnificent One?
The stars are made of the same metal as the Black Ring. Behold! You must build me 7 great pyramids with a disc of star metal atop each one. Only then can you forever release me from the abyss. Only then can you make me free.
That was a clip from Conan the Adventurer. Talk about a little intense content for children. The interdimensional, shape-shifting lizard kings David Icke is famous for speaking about demand that we build them 7 pyramids of power throughout the world. with star metal or monatomic gold elements as the capstones. In Masters of the Universe, there's another Serpent King who transcends dimensions, Skeletor. As he soars through the wormhole on his octagonal hovercraft, positioned between two cobras, using cosmic keys or vibratory musical notes correlated with sacred geometry to rip a hole through the fabric of space-time. In the film The Arrival, we see our 9/11 resonator, Charlie Sheen, stumble upon an enormous terraforming machine designed by an alien race to rapidly heat up the planet Earth to make it more habitable for them, while killing the entire human race in the process. An eerie fictional tale as we see our own polar caps melting at an alarming rate. Perhaps in reality, this warming trend is a much more natural event which is correlated with solar and galactic maximums. Perhaps this works in synergistic harmony with the re-emergence of hollow Earth civilizations, and a reuniting of the dual hemispheres of the human race. Mr. Sheen, you better get out of there right away. Nobody wants his secret getting out. In fact, they're going to trigger an alarm followed by beaming a picture of your face on multiple hexagonal monitors in just a second. Another creepy aspect of this film is the possible alien technology to make themselves appear as if they were completely human. A premise used in many sci-fi films such as They Live. Perhaps a little less fictional component of an interspecies commingling policy in the government archives. In the distant future, after the destruction of the moon, a primitive archaic society on the surface is governed by a group of hyper-intelligent subterranean telepaths, who entrain beasts to slaughter for them and give them an ample food supply. The Uber Morlock, played by Jeremy Irons, reveals that they have a case-like society, with each case nearly a different species in itself, fulfilling a different function. This is a dark and reptilian-perceived evolutionary timeline. Much as the elites of today utilize mind control and clever propaganda to force the lemming-like population into any sector of the maze they wish, this is not the distant future at all. This is present day. A parasitic consciousness is alive and well in our society and on our planet, and they have entirely too much power. It's time for us to balance out the chessboard.
Father, the fiery tears are made of metal.
Devouring consciousness.
Star metal.
Digesting power. Monster of energy. It's a monster. Kiss the snake on the tongue. Kiss the serpent.
Only a few stars have fallen. Set summons me. I must go to the pyramid at once.
As Skeletor transforms into a monatomic golden god in front of a rather menacing and alien Masonic Stargate, and demands He-Man and the rest of Eternia bow at his feet, we must utilize our intuition to discover what portions of the collective consciousness are responsible for this imagery. The cosmic keys are in our hands to play a symphony of holographic beauty, to craft and design this world and this life in any orientation and direction we choose. What chords will you play? What music will you make? All music in this presentation was off of Perdition City by Ulver. Join me in the extended version of this video at my website, labyrinthofthepsychonaut.com, where I will explore Harry Potter Serpent Sinks, Red Dragon, and more reptilian-infused 80s cartoons.